हेलो एवरीवन, हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड स्टडिंग हार्ड. सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर, इफ यू हैव गॉन थ्रू वेरी सीरियसली, एंड आई होप यू हैव गॉन थ्रू सीरियसली, बिकॉज वी आर ऑन अ वे ऑफ डीलिंग विद मोस्ट ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड मेजर इश्यूज ऑफ आर टॉपिक, ऑफ आर सब्जेक्ट रादर. So, last lecture we had started with an idea of studying what and how these gaseous material are interacting in the atmosphere. In the previous lecture also, we had seen some of the major gaseous material which are affecting the ozone, which is a major cause for atmospheric changes, which is a major cause for changes in rainfall, atmospheric temperature, as well as a major cause of what we call as a cyclone, wave motions, everything. So basically, gaseous material which is present in our atmosphere has one of the essential part for human existence. Okay, so that is agreeable part till right now, ki gaseous material ke bina ह्यूमन एग्जिस्टेंस या फिर किसी भी ऑर्गेनिज्म का एग्जिस्टेंस इज रादर नॉट एट ऑल पॉसिबल. सो दैट इज वन पार्ट जो हमने डिस्कस किया था. सिमिलरली हमने ये स्टार्ट किया था कि गैशियस मटेरियल हमें ऐसे स्टडी करने हैं अभी, जैसे कि हमने लास्ट टाइम स्टडी किया था कि मिथेन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, वॉट आर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दीज गैशियस मटेरियल, वॉट हैपन्स वेन मिथेन इज इन इंक्रीज्ड अमाउंट, when methane is in lower amount, what is the role of methane, as well as we had seen what is the role of carbon dioxide, if carbon dioxide is in more amount to kya hota hai, ye bhi humne kafi amount mein discuss kiya hai. Exactly iske pehle wale lecture mein we had started a topic connected to our previous topics, and the topic was called as acid rain, and we had studied what actually is the meaning of acid rain. Okay, so acid rain basically हमें याद रखना है सिर्फ it is a precipitation. Now this precipitation is a natural process, and acid rain of course is also a natural process. So basically acid rain में important क्या है फिर, so we have to study pH, और हमने pH भी study किया था कि if the pH is low it will be called as what, you had to answer me, and if the pH is high it is called as what. So if the pH is low, that means if it is less than 7, it will be called as an acidic nature content of pollutant or product. And if the pH is higher than 7, that means 7 ke upar agar chala jata hai, to uska color precipitation hota hai, bluish in color, shades of blue, and it is basically called as basic in nature, or else it can be also said as alkaline in nature. ओके, आपको ये दोनों वर्ड्स याद रखना है, दैट इज अल्कलाइन इन नेचर और बेसिक इन नेचर. ऑल्सो वी हैड डिस्कस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट वाटर विच वी एक्चुअली कंज्यूम इज हैविंग व्हाट पीएच, दैट इज 5.7, अप्रोक्सीमेटली 5.7, एंड ऑल्सो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड व्हाई इट इज 5.7, बिकॉज इट कंटेन्स मिनरल्स. नेक्स्ट वी हैड मूव्ड ऑन टू व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल कंसेप्ट ऑफ एसिड रेन, हाउ एसिड रेन टेक्स प्लेस, what is the basic criteria of anthropogenic acid creation or acid rain creation. So we had a discussion that it is artificially created, that means because of human existence, and the source of human existence is companies which is emitting out sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides. मैंने आपको ये भी बोला था, you have to remember these two words prominently, that is sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides. Reason is because nitrogen is one of the component which is not in a state of proper form. Okay, ये क्यों, ये हम बाद में discuss करेंगे. We had studied a chemistry of sulfur dioxide, that means how sulfur dioxide or sulfuric acid is formed, and we had also discussed a point that how sulfuric acid which is formed comes down on the earth, that means it is actually existing in a natural form. Sulfur dioxide is existing in a natural form or occurring in natural form as volcanic eruption, because volcanic eruption hota hai to sulfur dioxide रिलीज आउट होता है, जबकि नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड्स कब रिलीज होते हैं, जब थंडर लाइटनिंग या फिर बारिशों के टाइम पे लाइटनिंग स्ट्राइक्स होते हैं। सो लाइटनिंग स्ट्राइक्स भी हमने डिस्कस किया था एंड आई होप आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कि व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल मेथड ऑफ लाइटनिंग प्रोसेस। ओके, सो इट इज नॉट बेसिकली एनी काइंड ऑफ माइथोलॉजिकल स्टोरी और एनी काइंड ऑफ हिस्टोरिकल मेथड, बट इट इज एक्चुअली अ साइंस that it creates an friction and creates ions. Now, why these ions are created, I hope you have gone through it and I don't need to tell you. So, we'll today move with the next session, and the next session will be called as the chemistry of nitric acid, the causes of the actual process of acid rain, how acid rain takes place, because humne acid rain kaise hota hai, ye ek last diagram mein dekha tha. If you remember, we had discussed one through help of one picture that actually the process of acid rain formation includes the combination of two gases with that of the water body, that is cloud, and then it is coming down in the form of an acid. So that was our last discussion. So we will today look forward that how nitric acid is formed. Sulfuric acid is formed by combinations of reactions, okay, because it is one of the complex form. But nitric acid formation does not takes place that much process. Reason is because nitrogen oxides are binary compounds. That means they are the simple form of they are the compound which is formed by simple reaction or simple products. Also, but it has many different areas. That is, they are neutral in charge. Henceforth, it reacts very easily and can form an acid at only a single step. For example, aap agar dekh lo, yahan pe example I've given that NO2. So NO2 will be called as nitrogen dioxide. Okay. Similarly, the other products for nitrogen oxides will be NO, that is nitric oxide, ya fir NO3, that is nitrogen trioxide, ya fir N2O, that is nitrous oxide. So I told you that nitrogen oxide is not in a pure form. Jaise hume sulfur oxides mila hai, you can see over here, it's written as SO2, but we have not written over here it as NO2 or N2O2 or NO. Rather, we have plainly written it as NOx. Now, what does this X means? That means I can get this nitrogen in any form. Okay. So I can get this nitrogen with combination of oxygen in a form of NO, that is pure form, or NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide, or NO3, or N2O, or N2O2, etc. etc. Also, let me tell you, it has one of the complex form. Okay, that means nitrogen oxides, ye complex form may be appear hote hai, but even though they are in complex form, because they have a neutral charge, they can easily get combined with the water molecule and hydrogen molecule or hydroxyl molecule to form or to give a reaction. Now, for today, you have a homework that you have to comment in the give me the answer in the comment box. And the question is, listen to it carefully. I'm giving you the word and you have to tell me the formula. The word is oxatetrazole. It is OXATETRAZOLE. So it is oxatetrazole. So what is actually the formula for oxatetrazole? That is one of your questions. Now my second question for you is, you have to tell me what is the name of the formula I am giving to you, and the formula is N2O5. So you have to tell me the name. Okay, so for this you have to give me the answer in the comment box. So basically, the nitric acid, moving on to the chemical reaction, we find that, for example, okay, we are over here taking just an example as NO2. So again, keep in mind that it is NO2, but it can be an any form. So it will go into a simple reaction. It is not much complex reaction. So when NO2, for example, combines with OH ions It is because a neutral in charge, it will simply form in one reaction itself a nitric acid, that is HNO3. So the nitric acid does not go into much complex reactions similar to that of what we have seen for the sulfuric acid. Rather, it goes into a very simple reaction. And henceforth, we can also say that nitrogen or nitric acid or nitrogen oxides are much harmful than sulfur oxides. For the reason, because they can easily get converted from one form to another form. Okay, so that is one reason. Now, let's moving on to what are the basic causes for the formation of these products. So, it is very much clear, like we had said, that something should be there of human existence, like natural existence. We had seen in 1970s, there was a kind of study which cleared up that there are some components of nature also which are involved in these activity called as acid rain. But before that, around in 17th century, okay, so this question can be asked, so you have to note it down, that around in 17th century, a person named as, I've not written the name of the person over here, but you have to write down, the name of the person is John Elvin. I'll spell it out, J-O-H-N, John Elvin, E-V-E-L-Y-N, Elvin. Now, this was the person who told, actually, he made a research, observed, and he gave the conclusion that there is some problem in the air which is causing the marble and the limestone. Okay, ab marble and limestone kya hota hai? Ye ek aisa stone ka product hai jiski wajah se most of the statues and monuments are being made, because it is one of the even costlier, and at the same time it is one of the most shiny, most flexible kind of material which is used for statues, especially statues. Okay, एग्जाम्पल अगर मैं दूँ इसका तो आपको ताजमहल दिखेगा. इट इज़ वन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट विच इज फॉर्म्ड बिकॉज ऑफ सॉरी इज द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्ट दैट इज मार्बल्स एंड लाइमस्टोन. सो व्हाट दिस पर्सन टोल्ड दैट इज जॉन एल्विन, ही टोल्ड दैट देर इज समथिंग प्रॉब्लमेटिक इन द एयर विच इज कॉजिंग अ स्टोन स्पेशली द मार्बल एंड द लाइमस्टोन टू डिटोरिएट. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डिटोरिएट, दैट मीन्स पत्थर का पाउडर होना अपने आप शुरू हो जाता है, पत्थर अपने आप घिसते हैं, रस्टिंग होती है पत्थर की एंड पाउडरी फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट होना शुरू हो जाता है. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दैट, दैट मींस द स्टोन इज डिग्रेडिंग इटसेल्फ, वो ब्रेक डाउन हो रहा है अपने आप विदाउट एनी ह्यूमन एग्जिस्टेंस और ह्यूमन फोर्स. व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्ट, ऑफ कोर्स अ स्टोन विल कंप्लीटली डीजेनरेट, पूरी तरह से खत्म हो जाएगा एक लेवल के बाद में. So that was the observation of this person. But he was not given that much importance at that time. On another hand, his research was carried forward by many other people who were interested in these kind of research. And around in, again, 1852, a person called as Robert Angus Smith. इन्होंने कहा था कि yes, there is a problem. And the problem is, कि इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन होने की वजह से सबसे ज़्यादा सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड एंड नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड इलिमिनेट हो रहे हैं, और ये जो पोल्यूटेंट है ये आके डिपॉजिट हो रहे हैं स्टोन्स पे, दैट इज स्पेशली लाइमस्टोन एंड मार्बल, जो जॉन एल्विन ने कहा था. एंड व्हेन इट इज गेटिंग डिपॉजिटेड दे फाउंड दैट द स्टोन इज कम्प्लीटली चेंजिंग इट्स कलर, नॉट ओनली चेंजिंग इट्स कलर बट इट इज ऑल्सो चेंजिंग इट्स शेप, दैट मीन्स द डस्ट फॉर्म हो रहा है, स्टोन का डस्ट कन्वर्जन हो रहा है, और वो पूरी तरह से जो स्टैच्यू होता है वो अपना शेप लूज कर देता है. सो दैट वॉज द रिजल्टेंट वॉट ही गेव. एंड फ्रॉम देयर एक्चुअली द आइडिया ऑफ एसिड रेन स्टार्टेड, दैट मीन्स ही वॉज द पर्सन हु गेव द कंसेप्ट ऑफ एसिड रेन. ओके, सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज टू नेम्स, दैट वॉज जॉन एल्विन एंड द सेकेंड नेम इज रॉबर्ट एंग्विस स्मिथ. नाउ वॉट दे टोल्ड, this could happen because of human existence, and human existence mein kya hota hai, it is basically because of burning of fossil fuel. Burning of fossil fuel sabko pata hai, that is aap ped kaatoge aur us ped ke material ko, that is whatever the wood you are getting from the as a firewood, you'll be using it, okay, for your domestic purposes. Now it can be anything, But this wood is creating, of course, much more amount of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide. That was one part. Fine. That is okay. Because finally, wood is made up of carbon and oxygen products. So it will not cause that much of effect. But it is causing. The major resultant, what they found out was the product which are used to generate the electricity is having more effect and it is causing more pollutant to release out in the air. Especially the pollutants are sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides. Now, what is this energy generating power stations doing? Aapko pata hai ki generation, power generation kaisa hota hai. Like we know the dams, because of the flow of the water, it is falling on the turbines and the turbine then creates the electricity by the rotational motion. So that is the basic idea of generation electricity. But there is another interesting part of generating electricity is that some cities, some countries now also they are using coal, that means a charcoal as a product for generating this electricity. They are burning on this charcoal, they are reusing the charcoal. And because they are reusing the charcoal we know it is made up of hard carbon. Okay, so when it is of hard carbon, aap soch sakte ho ki jitna zyada carbon emitted hoga, utna hi zyada pollutant create hoga. So that is the same thing what these people found out later on, that the carbon products jahan pe use hote hai electricity generation ke liye, especially charcoal, us pollutant, उस इंडस्ट्री में से जो पोल्यूटेंट निकलेगा उसमें से 2/3 पार्ट ये सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड होगा और 1/4 पार्ट दैट इज नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड्स. ऑल्सो लेटर ऑन सम स्टडीज विच वर फाउंड आउट बाय द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एज वेल एज मेनी अदर कंट्रीज विद द हेल्प ऑफ कन्वेक्शंस. कन्वेक्शंस ये वर्ड आपको सिर्फ याद रखना है, विल बी डिस्कसिंग दिस वर्ड इन द वेरी नेक्स्ट सेशंस. सो कन्वेक्शंस में ये डिसाइड हुआ या फिर ये स्टडी हुआ that it is major role of vehicle also and oil refineries also, because again the same part comes, that is vehicles and oil refineries actually they are giving you out the problem of carbon, and when it is carbon it is mixing up with your products and giving a chemical reaction with sulfurs and nitrogen oxides in a form of ions and creating the acidic effects. So this is just an overview, you can snapshot it. ये हमने पहले भी डिस्कस किया है दैट हाउ द एसिड रेन फॉर्मेशन टेक्स प्लेस, बट व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन इज दिस दैट यू हैव टू लुक फॉरवर्ड. आई एम गिविंग यू अ बोल्ड टू वर्ड्स दैट डार्कर, दैट इज ड्राई डिपोजिशन एंड वेट डिपोजिशन. सो आई टोल्ड यू इन द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑल्सो दैट एसिड रेन डज नॉट मीन दैट इट इज कमिंग आउट, दैट मीन्स कमिंग बैक टू अर्थ इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ रेन ओनली. ये हमने पहले भी डिस्कस किया था. Sometimes it is coming in the form of a rain, sometimes it is form in a snow, sometimes it is in a fog, hail, etc. So, ये सब wet हो गए. यानि कि rain, snow, hail, ये सारी गीली चीजें होती है. तो it is coming down in a form of a wet deposition. Okay? So, it will be called as a wet deposition. And the other part, for example, जैसे हमने क्या था कि sometimes it is coming down in a form of a dust. Okay? So, dust, particulates, particles, aerosols, gaseous material in a form of a cyclone or haze, या फिर in a form of like whirlpools, huge whirlpools. इसके साथ में भी जो products आते हैं acidic products, for example sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide, sorry nitrogen oxide, they will be settling down on the earth directly rather than settling down in a form of a mixing up with water material. They will directly settle down on the earth and then they will start its reaction. So that is again an major process you have to look forward, but this process or this particulate will be called as a dry deposition. So basically acid rain, what I mean to say is in two forms, that is wet deposition and dry deposition. So wet deposition is something which means the acid is coming or mixing up in the clouds, the sulfur and nitrogen gases are mixing up in the clouds and then they are mixing up and forming a chemical reaction and then they are coming down on the earth in the form of a rain, fog, smog or hail. On another hand, dry deposition mein kya hota hai? Ye directly earth surface pe settle down ho jate hai because kafi zyada tufaan aate hai to iske saath mein ye niche aa sakte hai and when they settle down over there, what they do, they start reacting with the water material which is present on the earth itself. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर अर्थ पे कोई सेटल डाउन हो जाता है या फिर अर्थ सर्फेस पे डायरेक्टली सेटल डाउन हो जाता है तो क्या होता है, सेटल डाउन होने के बाद में इट रिएक्ट्स विद द स्मॉल वाटर पार्टिकुलेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर थोड़ा सा मॉइस्चर होता है कहीं पे प्लांट वाटर बॉडी पे, तो ये सरफेस पे जाएगा, वाटर बॉडी पे रिएक्ट करेगा एंड इट विल स्टार्ट फॉर्मिंग एन एसिड. नाउ व्हाट इज द रिएक्शन ऑफ दिस? द प्लांट गेट्स बर्न आउट. ओके, सो डायरेक्टली प्लांट पे बारिश ना गिरते टाइम एसिड सल्फर के फॉर्म में डिपॉजिट होगा, देन रिएक्ट होगा, और रिएक्ट होने के बाद में वो एसिड रिएक्शन वहीं पे करेगा एंड इट विल कॉज एन हार्म टू द प्लांट्स, और मे बी इफ इट इज ऑन द वाइल्ड लाइफ इट विल कॉज अ वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रॉब्लम. नाउ वन थिंग मोर, इट डज नॉट लुक फॉरवर्ड फॉर वेदर द प्लांट इज अ ह्यूज प्लांट और अ स्मॉल प्लांट. इट कैन रिएक्ट ऑन एनी प्लांट, दैट इज हर्ब, श्रब्स और बुशेज और ह्यूज प्लांट्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. ओके, one more reason of desert having more such kind of salty areas is because desert itself is very much hard in nature, and if the acids, because companies are there everywhere, so if the acids gets deposited over there, the fertile land is completely lost, and henceforth we find that desert area is expanding. Jo humne last lecture mein discuss kiya tha, that desert area are expanding very fast. This is one more reason for it. So this is just a basic idea of what are the effects of acid rain, but we'll just go into the very fast reaction of how acid rain does the work. So jaise humne bola tha, acid rain basically works on the non-living thing and it deteriorates. So you can find out, like I've given in the picture, the Taj Mahal then, that means when the pollution of acid rain was not much, it was white in color, while it is palish yellowish in color right now, and the reason like color change नहीं हो रहा है, सिर्फ ये पेलिश येलोइश दिख रहा है, is because the marble is deteriorating itself. Marble घिसना शुरू हो गया है, marble का powder form होना शुरू हो जा रहा है. Now consider if it is going on for centuries together, of course one day the monument will fall down, and that is the problem where the government of India is now taking high risk to actually protect it with the help of some material, especially the material which are used for protecting these kind of monuments is nothing else but the products which are naturally available. For example, you might be knowing that alum is one kind of product which can actually protect, but if it reacts with, again there is a problem, if it reacts with the acid material it will cause a different reaction. So there is actually a problem which is occurring. Similarly, in the second picture you can see, it can be very much clear in the second picture rather, that we have a statue which were years back, and now because of the acid rain it has completely lost half its structure. So basically acid is causing a problem on the structures, monuments, bridges, and if this question arises that which is the actually problem for the Taj Mahal, so it is Mathura refinery, you should keep in mind, and which is the major gas, that is sulfur dioxide. Also on living organism, for example, like we people, human being, or maybe animals or any kind of other organism, if you inhale, ab agar inhale kar dete ho sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides ko, so it will directly cause a problem on your breathing. That means aapke lungs ke alveoli jo hote hai, jo aapke oxygen ko capture karte ho, wo band hona shuru ho jate hai, and the resultant is that you will be suffering from a problem called as asthma and bronchitis, which is commonly seen in our country now and then. And the reason, now you might have understood, is just because the tiny particles which is coming out of the vehicle emission is actually entering our lungs. So we are basically facing the problem of asthma and bronchitis is one of the major cause. Similarly goes with other living organisms also. Like if the acid gets deposited in the river water, it will react with the living organisms and the products of living of the water bodies, and what will happen, this will make the organism to deteriorate its life. That means unme bhi oxygen ka problem aata hai, lung mein problem aana shuru ho jata hai, and it will actually kill the fishes. Now over here there's a picture of kill the dead fishes, but also you can find the more drastic effects to be found in the upper picture. For example, the fish, or for example let me say, will go with a small microbe body which is in the water, that is a plant. in a water. If this plant gets saturated with the acid material, that is sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides, which is coming on from either dry form or either from a wet form, it can be anything. If it gets deposited, it will pass itself, because fishes kis pe feed karenge? To of course plants pe feed karenge. And if this fish is eaten up further by a bird, so ye carbon acid deposition kis mein chala jayega? Bird mein chala jayega. So you can see that the complete chain is formed. And one more thing, this chain increases. Ye decrease nahi hota hai, ye increase hote jata hai day by day. Because of course you can find fish ek plant to nahi khayegi, it will consume two or three plants. Okay. Similarly, the bird will not at a time only have a fish. Main aaj ek hi fish khaunga, aisa to nahi bolega. It will have more than two or three fishes. So it gets increased. So that is the problem of acid rain. That is, it is passing on. Acid is passing on very easily from one organism to another organism. It is, jaise humne kaha tha ki it is causing a problem with the trees. So you can see over here that agar potassium, calcium and magnesium absorb karne ka strength plant mein nahi rahega. To kyun nahi rahega? Because acid jo hota hai sulfur aur nitrogen ka, wo surface pe saturate ho jayega. And because ye saturate ho jayega, to magnesium, calcium aur potassium block ho jayega. अगर प्लांट्स को ये नहीं मिला तो फोटोसिंथेसिस नहीं कर पाएंगे, एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स इट विल बी अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर देम. ऑफ कोर्स देयर आर सॉल्यूशंस फॉर इट आल्सो, एंड द सॉल्यूशन इज यू हैव टू ऐड सम फिल्टर्स टू योर व्हीकल. ओके, फिल्टर्स आपका स्मोक एब्जॉर्ब कर लेंगे और आपका व्हीकल उतना स्मोक रिलीज आउट नहीं करेगा. सिमिलरली कंपनीज में भी यही कर सकते हैं हम, दैट इज चिमनीज में हम फिल्टर्स लगा सकते हैं, पोल्यूटेड फिल्टर्स जो एब्जॉर्ब कर लेगा. And then the rest of the smoke will be released out. Similarly, government policies bhi kafi run ho rahi hai. Aur government policy mein kuch policies hai like flue gas desulfurization. Now that's a very different process. So I'll not explain it right now. But you have to tell me that if you are interested in listening to this process, we'll just discuss in one topic about this process, one lecture about this topics. So it is flue gas desulfurization, fluid bed combustion. These are the process basically, and Helsinki protocol is basically a conference which was conducted, and it gave a result that how to control the emission of sulfur dioxide. Also, there were some changes made in the constitution, that is called as amendment. Okay, so basically kuch amendment ho chuke hai, aur ye amendment kya kehte hai ki how the clean air should be maintained, and the amendment was called as amendment was made in 1990. So you have to keep in mind these few things, because it is very minute topic to be studied, and you have to study minutely only. So we'll meet in the next lecture. Till then, study hard.